M&S Creativus presents A Word for Every Generation That Knows No Fashion.
Greetings. I hope and trust I still find you well, my dear friends. We have the privilege of drinking from the well of wisdom, particularly in the book of Numbers, for the last time. Come with me to the book of Numbers. We are at chapter 27. We want to begin reading at verse number 12. It reads as follows. And the Lord said to Moses, go up into this mountain of Abarim, and behold the land I have given to the Israelites. And when you have seen it, you also shall be gathered to your departed people, as Aaron your brother was gathered. For you disobeyed my order in the wilderness of Zin during the strife of the congregation to uphold my sanctity by strict obedience to my authority at the water before their eyes. These are the waters of Meribah in Kadesh in the wilderness of Zin. May the good Lord bless the reading of his word as we spend a moment in prayer. Let us pray. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for the privilege of calling upon your name. Dear Father, there comes a time when we have to come to an end, call it quits, and retire. How we pray, dear Lord, that our service with thee may be filled with days of joy and pleasure. Be with us as we consider your word this morning. In Jesus' name we prayed and we ask, amen. My dear friends, allow me to raise just 5 points as we take off into our working week. At point number one, notice that God calls upon Moses and he says unto Moses, go up unto the mountain of Abarim. This is his mountaintop experience, the last that he shall experience. And God says as he gets there, he says, and I will show you the land I have given to the Israelites. What do I want to raise here? God takes time to reveal his plans. And he reveals his plans to his subordinate. He reveals his plans to his teammate. He reveals his plans to his partner. Moses and God have been on a rescue mission to rescue the children of Israel from Egypt and take them all the way into Canaan. As they go through this experience, God says, now, my friend, I want to show you the land which I have given to the Israelites. Before we come back into the Bible, may I encourage you, in your spaces of work, are your subordinates aware of the bigger plan? Are they aware how far you have gone in fulfilling the mission that you set out to accomplish? God is leading by example. God is setting a clear example. Show those you are working with how far you have gone. And I love the way then God now speaks to Moses. He says, I'm going to show you the land which I have given to the children of Israel. Not the land that I will give to the children of Israel, but he already speaks in the past tense. As far as God is concerned, all that we have has already been given unto us. It is only up to us to claim it. It is only up to us to realize it. It is only up to us to walk into those things that God has prepared for us. This very week has been given unto us. This month has been given unto us. The year 2021 has already been given unto us. Are we ready to go out and claim it? Are we ready to go out and enjoy it? And point number two, notice that when he has been shown all these things, God now then says at verse number 14, you are going to be gathered to your people. It's verse 18, you are going to be gathered to your people just like Aaron. You are also going to die, Moses, on the top of this mountain. Why are you going to die? Because you disobeyed me. There are those who walk with God, talk to God face to face, and are constantly in conversation with him. This is no insurance that the cold finger of death shall not touch us. We are going to die. Death is not for those who are unrighteous. Death is not only for those who have not met with God. Even those who have a face-to-face contact and relationship with God do die. And I want to stress this. As we go through this season of pain, many a time we ask the question, why do we have to die? Why do our loved ones die? Even those who are righteous, they do die. come back to the workspace. You have had to have a farewell dinner where you are bidding farewell to those who have retired, those who have hung their boots, those who have said it is enough, and they go and rest. This is a moment in life and in the workspace that comes upon every one of us. Let us prepare for that day when we shall retire. Let us prepare for that day, not when we are going to die, but when we shall be bid farewell to, when they say unto us, thank you, Mr. MK, for your services. May God bless you as you go and enjoy your retirement. May that day come and find me ready. And I hope it's going to find you ready to exit your workspace, just as Moses did exit his workspace. Point number three. Moses is going to die, and God gives him a reason. Amongst one of these reasons is, besides age, of course, Moses, you did wrong when you had an opportunity to do right by me. You are not going to go into the promised land. You are going to die at this point. This is where our walk ends. I am closing this chapter here. God is simply saying it is here and no further for you, my friend. Why? Because you did wrong. There are consequences for doing wrong. We cannot go into the promised land having done wrong by God. Moses at least lost an opportunity to enter the earthly promised land. How much more shall it be for us who have one chance to enter the next promised land? And only one wrong deed can stand between entry into heaven and remaining on earth. May we order our lives. May we order our choices in such a way that we do not do wrong by God. And the Son, Jesus Christ, is available and has availed the Holy Spirit to teach us and to remind us so that we may keep his commandments, so that we may continue to be on the straight and narrow and not lose because of just one incident. Moses made one mistake. That's all it took, and he lost out on Canaan. One mistake is all it will take for you and I to lose out on heaven. Doesn't the book of James chapter 2 verse 10 say, you may keep all the commandments, but if you are guilty in violating one, you are guilty of them all. Just violating one commandment is all that it shall take for you to lose out on a kingdom to come. Point number four. Notice this, even though Moses has messed up in Kadesh, in the wilderness of Zin, God goes on to work with Moses pretty well. They work so well as if Moses has never done any wrong. Moses has never erred. And I want to challenge you and I, especially in the workspaces. There are people who have done wrong by us. There are people who have messed up. There are people who have dropped the ball. There are people who did not live up to our expectations. But the passage shows us that God worked with Moses in spite of his being a previous offender. God works pretty well with Moses, even though he has messed up in the past, as if he has not done anything wrong. God works with him because he is the God of second chances. How I pray you and I can give others a second, third, and fourth chance, because God has led by example. We all need a second chance. Point number five, as we near the end. The reason why Moses has to step aside. It is because the congregation led him to sin. In the various spaces of work, it is possible. Some of us occupy positions that have a high level of stress. Please manage your stress levels. Do not lose heaven on account of the teams you are leading, like Moses. Do not lose heaven on account of those who are given to always complain and they'll never see any good in what you do. Make it a point. Manage the pressure. Manage the pressure. Failure to do so, it will cost you way more than it cost Moses. Moses lost Canaan and got heaven. What about you and I? If we do not manage this pressure, we will lose eternal life. It is my prayer and my hope that God will keep you until you meet again next Monday. May his blessings ever be upon you.